I look at the presidential process, both the current president and his opponents, kind of like the Giants and the Patriots in the Super Bowl. It's very exciting, and you can get really sucked into who's going to win. But unlike the Super Bowl, politics is like a sport overrun with steroids and drug abuse. And so if you get lost in the identity of Mitt Romney or Newt Gingrich or Barack Obama, it's a perfect distraction from the fact that six major industries are funding all of our political candidates, and all of our political candidates are rigging our banking system, rigging our tax code, rigging our trade policy, and ultimately extracting our country on behalf of special interests. And I think you got to be very careful about thinking that a culture of heroes and villains, whether it's the president or his opponents, is going to solve the problem, when it's going to require both political parties are held to task for their willingness to continue to accept bribes from special interests to corrupt our core policies of banking, trade, and tax. I think Obama has been a colossal disappointment and betrayal for the American people. I think that he speaks wonderfully, and his rhetoric is incredibly appealing, and it's good for the lizard brain. You hear it and you're like, yes, I feel that, I believe that. It's wonderfully manipulative politics. But when you look at the underlying actual policy decisions, the decision to continue to facilitate a $30 trillion ongoing cover-up of a banking system that has a completely unreformed, too-big-to-fail system based on a $700 trillion secret gambling parlor called credit default swaps that hasn't brought into the light, that was done by this president's Secretary of the Treasury with this president's endorsement. When you look at the failure to reconcile the mortgage crisis, 50% of the people in Florida underwater, 50% of the people in Nevada underwater, the people that can't move to take jobs, people can't move to deal with their families, that's all under the direction of this president, who claims that he's in favor of not having two sets of rules, only having one set of rules, and yet he's one of the most prolific appliers of those two sets of rules. He said he would deal with China on trade policy. Didn't happen. Said he'd deal with China on trade policy, didn't happen. Unfortunately, his opponents are equally corrupt, which is why my attention goes to the reform of the electoral process, getting money out of politics, ending the gerrymandering, so that it is much more difficult for any of these politicians or the special interests that buy them to continue to do what they're doing to this country and our government, but to understand that we are on the verge of a tremendous opportunity if we do resolve those things, and they can be resolved. In fact, people are resolving them outside of our government, and if we better understand things, we can better solve the problem. You can't solve a problem that you don't understand, and my goal was to try to make an accessible document, and not only book, but also the website with greedybastards.com and the Connect the Dots illustrations, to make all of this content, A, more accessible, and to enroll people in a bigger conversation about how we're going to realign our interests as 311 million Americans. I'll never run for office. I'm running for cable guy, and I actually believe that the more powerful position for somebody like me with my skills is as a communicator outside of the system, provoking the apparatus, than to get absorbed into sort of the ego or the arrogance of believing that participating would in some way be more valuable. In my case, I believe to be a rabble-rouser from the outside is my highest value proposition.